Namaskar friends, this is NJ, your host on this channel. In this video, we are going to have our discussion on the upcoming transit of planet Mercury, which on November 2nd is going to be entering the sign of Libra. And from November 2nd till November 20th, it is going to be transiting in the sign of Libra only. So what kind of result this transit of Mercury is going to create, it's going to manifest, we will have our discussion first on the generalized result of this transit, and then in the second half we will try to understand the customized results for all the ascendants. So friends, to begin with, like whenever we talk about the transit of the inner planets, it becomes very important because on a small span of time it holds the power to trigger some opportunity for you. Now when we talk about the importance of Mercury, so definitely Mercury, which represents commercial activity, it is a good planet, important planet for the students, for people in business, in commercial activities, any sort of self-employed or skilled profession you have. So you also need the support of the planet Mercury. You are a performing artist, you are an actor, so somehow Mercury becomes very important for all of us. Friends, trust me, if I were to say in transit, if there is only one planet which actually gave very sudden, chaotic, unpredictable result, so that is always the Mercury. Like I have seen so many times, the moment Mercury is going to turn retrograde, and God forbid if it is happening in my chart over my important planets or over my Dushtana Bhav conjunct with nodes, trust me, I have been at the receiving end of the confusion. So now the concern is that just because I know astrology, I know about the planetary vibration, I do proper Vedic remedies, I'm also very disciplined as well. So I do not, you know, kind of lose out on these kind of, sudden triggering circumstances. But the problem is that we live in a social society. So I can only control myself. I cannot control the behavior of other people around me. So whenever Mercury turns retrograde, it always creates, confusion, some kind of dispute, some sort of argument. And majority of the times, the reason of all of that confusion is of without any reason. So now the point which I'm trying to make over here is that, friends, so this is the bad or vulnerable side of the planet Mercury. But when we talk about the good side, and specifically pertaining to Mercury's transit in the Libra sign, so definitely it is a very conducive, very favorable placement for Mercury to be in, for any sort of commercial activity, for making a very rational, very important and very careful decision by taking into consideration all the pros and cons. So whether you are in any sort of law related field, you have your own business, you are a stand-up comedian, for any sort of pleasurable activities, travels, exploration, making new friends, new relationship, from all of those perspective, the transit of Mercury in the sign of Libra can be seen as a very good sign. And friends, like the way, for example, if you are already a Vedic follower, so as you know that very soon, like the moment Mercury is going to enter the sign of Libra, so just after couple of days only, we are also going to have the occasion, the auspicious festival of Diwali as well. Diwali is the occasion where people celebrate, they visit each other's house, like your friends, your family, your acquaintances. So there is a lot of positive energy, positive vibe, which this transit of Mercury in the Libra sign is going to be creating for all of us. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to share, because now what is going to be happening is that, specifically from the Mercury's perspective, because you cannot even overlook this fact that if there is goodness in the society, in the world, so there is badness as well. Now the problem is that whenever we talk about any sort of unethical, unlawful activity, so the problem is that people straight away look at Saturn or like Mars or Rahu. But trust me, I have done a research on a lot many charts of, you know, like when I was working on the lines of the criminal psychology and all, I started that playlist on my Hindi channel, but I stopped after a while. So now I actually found the resonance that Mercury was found to be the chief element in the charts of majority of the people with criminal mindset, because these days crimes are not only taking place with a gun or with fist fight. Majority of the crimes are taking place with deception, with treachery, online frauds. So because of which, you will also find Mercury responsible for all these underhanded activities. Now, why I brought this thing up? Because after this, Mercury is going to enter the sign of Scorpio. So from 20th of November till 9th of December, Mercury is going to be in the Scorpio sign, and not only that, it is also going to be conjunct with Ketu and briefly with Sun as well. So I'm going to make a separate video on that. But right now, the good times of, you know, celebration, of travels, of friendship, new relationship, commercial gain, those times are here because Mercury is about to enter the sign of Libra. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of the general results guidelines for this transit of Mercury in the Libra sign. So not only Mercury is going to be present in the Libra, but it is also going to get the support from the planet Sun and planet Mars as well. So because of which there is a lot of heated energy which is going in the functioning of Libra, and Libra does not create a lot of chaos like the way when we talk about, even to an extent, like Scorpio, Pisces, even the water signs can give you some sort of emotional, you know, instincts and turmoils and sudden surge of energy. But Libra is a very balanced energy. No matter planets are concentrated, you know, getting hoarded up over here, but still it is nothing to worry about for any ascendant or any specific zodiac sign. So now, friends, we will start our discussion. Just in brief, we will look at that what kind of results this transit of Mercury is going to bring for all the ascendants. So starting with the Aries ascendant native. So definitely, friends, Mercury, although is not a very positive planet for you, but the only thing is that Mercury for the Aries ascendant native, it represents your discriminatory intelligence, your true prowess, your true valor, your strength is somehow being determined by the planet Mercury, because it has got the rulership of your courage, house of courage, and house of the competitive spirit. So now, as the Mercury is going to enter the seventh house, this can be seen as a very good time specifically for inviting new contacts, new relationship, gains in commercial activity, any sort of initiative, new steps which you are planning to take. You are in any sort of competitive, you know, sport, competitive exam, you're about to appear. So this transit of Mercury in your seventh house is definitely going to be creating some very positive energy. And like the way I have already mentioned this thing, that we are heading towards some positive, auspicious, festive season as well. So for Mercury's transit in the seventh house is definitely going to be, you know, kind of creating energy of friendliness, camaraderie, brotherhood, travels, short journeys. So from all of those perspective, this transit of Mercury for the Aries ascendant native can be seen as a very good news. Moving ahead, friends, now if you want to understand the transit results for all the Taurus ascendant natives. So friends, in your case, like the way I have already mentioned this thing, that for you guys, Mercury becomes a very important planet for you because Mercury has got the rulership. Because see, Taurus ascendant is originally the second house energy. Trust me, I have met so many Taurus ascendant native well established in business, world. And the good part and the defining part about these people is that is their good, fine, efficient management of finances. No matter how much money you are making, how much lucky you have remained in terms of, you know, making good money, but unless and until you do not know how to efficiently manage it, so no matter how much you will make, it will still keep on draining out. So now the good part over here is that, or the strength of the Taurus ascendant native is that their financial management tend to remain very fine, and somehow the answers of that is hidden with the dignity and the strength of Mercury in their chart, because Mercury has got the rulership of their house of finances and the fifth house of speculation, intellect, risk taking. So now, friends, just because Mercury is going to be entering your sixth house, so I would say, friends, that definitely your sixth house is getting accentuated. So for anyone, like for example, you are a service professional or you are in any sort of corporate setting, so this transit of Mercury in the sixth house can actually create some new opportunity. And you can also look at it in this way, that let's say for example, for long you have been kind of at the receiving end of debts, of any of the concerns that in your daily work life things are not working out, machines are breaking down, or any sort of those concerns of, you know, any sort of breakdown, any sort of hiccups, any fixing up of things which is required. So this transit of Mercury might give you a chance. For all those people who are in any sort of speculative nature of work, so I would say, just because in sixth house, the transit of your house lord of finances and speculation going in the sixth house is still a very sensitive energy. So I would say till the time at least Jupiter is not going to make its shift, I would say that take very calculative risk. So do not go beyond your means. And I would say for any sort of, there could be a little bit of the concerns of your partner becoming very demanding, or in love and romantic relationship, this could also create an energy that suddenly there is a lot of, expectations, or, duties and responsibilities might be expected a lot out of you in the relationship front. So just try to remain prepared on that ground. But apart from that, in your daily work life, the intelligence of Mercury is definitely going to improve your work conditions, your relations with the people you work with. Moving ahead, friends. Now, if you want to understand the transit results for all the Gemini ascendant natives. So definitely, friends, Mercury is your ascendant lord. Its transit becomes very important for you guys. And as you can see that in transit, your ascendant lord and the fourth house lord is going to be transiting in the fifth house, which is definitely a very positive time. So I would say, friends, try to encash as much as you can. So I have mentioned that thing so many times that fifth house also has a pleasure seeking side of it as well. So yes, definitely your personality is something which is very, inquisitive, always curious for knowledge. You want to travel, you want to explore the world. But along with that, when we talk about these kind of prime time of the transit, so I would say try to encash on this opportunity as well, this window of opportunity as well. So I would say, friends, any sort of speculation, stock market trading, if that is getting qualified in your case, you can get benefited. You are still a student, so the students can definitely get benefited because of the transit of a planet of intelligence, education in your house of education. And along with that, friends, for love, romance, this can be seen as a good time, short journeys, travel with your friends. So all of those prospects are getting promised because of the transit of Mercury in the fifth house. And friends, like the way, there has been so many things which has been written in the holy scriptures. Like, for example, the moment Mercury is going to enter the sign of Scorpio, it is going to get conjunct with Ketu. So many times this also happened that all those people who are adopted, they get to know about their parents, about their foster parents. So that actually create a lot of energy. But right now, we do not have to worry much about that, because in your case, the transit of Mercury in your fifth house is definitely going to enhance the prospects of your money making abilities, or anything to do with the connection, financial opportunities. This transit of Mercury in your fifth house is definitely going to be creating some positive energy. The good part over here is that because Mercury is your ascendant lord, which determines your life force, and it is also your fourth house lord, so something which gives us emotional fulfillment. So I would say whatsoever field or nature of work you are engaged in, whether you are an actor, whether you are on a leadership role, you are an accountant, so whatsoever your hobbies, your areas of interest are, you will be able to put forth your best efforts. And for the freelance people, they might also remain lucky in encashing on some good opportunities as well. And as fifth house is eighth house from the 10th house, so for all those people who are applying for job change or something new role on their job front, so that this transit in the fifth house can also create some positive energy as well. Moving ahead, friends, for all the Cancer ascendant natives, so friends, in your case, Mercury has got the rulership of your 12th house, and it has also got the rulership of your 3rd house. And in transit, it is going to be entering your 4th house. So friends, as you know, this thing that Mercury is not a very favorable planet for you guys. The second thing is that even from Mercury's perspective as well, we have got to know from your perspective, but from Mercury's perspective, the 4th house in the original Kalpurush Kundli is not a very favorable placement for Mercury. So I would say try not to be very, very anxious. Even when we talk about, any of the unpredictable, kind of eccentric behavior of your friends or people, your siblings, or any of the person in your locality, in your neighborhood. So try not to get, very offended, or try not to get overwhelmed because of the behavior of other people, because the transit of Mercury in the fourth house might make you very much accountable, or getting affected because of the unreasonable behavior of other people. So on emotional plane, you have to protect yourself. But when we talk about Mercury, which in itself is a planet of, discriminatory intelligence, commercial expertise, so if in your case any of the fourth house related matters are getting qualified, so for example, you work in anything to do with home decor, anything to do with the, you know, having your own jewelry store, anything to do with the construction, real estate, luxurious goods, gifting items. So you can also get benefited, some opportunity can get generated. We are already heading towards some festive, weeks and time periods. So I would say commercial gain can still be anticipated, but on an emotional plane, you have to protect your energies, specifically not taking the accountability and headache on the account of the eccentric behavior of other people. Moving ahead, friends, now if you want to understand the transit results for all the Leo ascendant natives. So friends, in your case, as you can fairly see that Mercury is a very, very important planet for you for all sort of opportunities, financial gains. So Mercury governs all of these two houses for you. And in transit, Mercury is going to enter your third house. So which can be seen as a very good time. Third house is a house of, you know, our initiatives, our efforts, our socialization, our influence. So I would say definitely if you are a freelance person, anything to do with business, awaiting some sort of funding, some sort of investments. So this transit of Mercury in the third house can be seen as a very beneficial time. And let's say, for example, friends, if your nature of work is little bit uncertain, it is contractual in nature, or you are an actor, performing artist, you are always looking forward to the right set of auditions. So I would say that this transit of Mercury in your third house is not only favorable for some travels, some new contacts, new relationship, but also from the perspective of new opportunity can get generated because of the transit of Mercury in your third house. So this could be some financial opportunity, or this could be some influential person coming in your way and might play an important role in connecting the dots towards your success. Moving ahead, friends, now if you want to understand the results for all the Virgo ascendant natives. So definitely, friends, Mercury is a very important planet for you. It is your ascendant lord and your 10th house lord. And in transit, Mercury is going to be entering your second house. So I would say, friends, that specifically if in your case, you are a banker, you are in any sort of accounting field, you have your own family business, anything to do with public speaking and all of that. So I would say that this transit of Mercury in your second house is definitely going to be creating some very positive results. So I would say that if for long you have been looking forward to, you know, asking for some important role, or like the way I have already mentioned this thing, public speaking is an important part of your nature of work. So this transit of Mercury is definitely going to make or enhance your communication, your eloquency in your speech. The second thing is that, friends, the commercial perspective as well, this transit is creating some very positive energy in your work front. Because try to understand this thing that for Mercury to be transiting in your second house, so it is going to be transiting fifth house from your 10th house of career. So even on your professional front, if you want to speculate something, take a risk, take a chance, you know, for any nature of work, so this is the right time when the planetary vibrations is definitely going to help you, support you. Moving ahead, friends, now if you want to understand the transit results for all the Libra ascendant natives. So friends, in your case, the transit of Mercury is going to take place right over there in your first house. So try to understand this thing that Mercury definitely has got the rulership of your 12th house, but it has also got the rulership of your 9th house as well. So I would say that anything to do with spirituality, anything to do with travels of exploration, any connection with foreign lands, foreigners, or any international business, if that is getting qualified in your case. So the transit of Mercury right over there in your first house is definitely going to bring opportunities, gains and benefits for you. Now the good part is that, friends, like the way, just because you are a Libra ascendant by yourself, so that means your decision making, your relationship management is definitely your forte. Having a strong expertise in commercial activities, having that charisma in your personality. Because when we talk about, see, the truth is the Venusian driven people, pure Venusian archetype, are tend to remain very lucky in actually becoming a center of attention or attracting all sort of positive connection and relationship in their life. And because of the transit of Mercury, a planet which is a very jovial planet, which represents commercial, social activities, travels, exploration. So coming right over there in your first house is definitely a very positive indication, whether for any sort of commercial interest, whether for inviting new relationship, or whether for any sort of spiritual merits as well. The support of the luck helping you, supporting you. So even from all of those perspective, this transit of Mercury seems to be very positive for you. So if in your case, you you are in the field of PR, advertising, judiciary, where your intelligence, your problem solving, your logics, your presentation becomes an integral part of your nature of work. So this transit of Mercury is definitely going to be bringing some very good news for all of you guys. Moving ahead, friends, for all the Scorpio ascendant natives, I feel bad to say this thing, friends, because many times what happens is that I smile in between. So people get offended that why I'm chuckling and, you know, not empathizing in their concern or in their, you know, matter of worry because of the problems created by planetary transit. But it's just like that. It is a small phase of the transit of the planets. And the beauty over here is that that is the only reason we listen to these kind of videos, so that we can plan ourselves accordingly. Trust me, whenever I have given this example, if Mercury turns retrograde, those circumstances get generated. But how will I react in the face of those circumstances? The free will is always with us. So the only thing which I want to say to all the Scorpio ascendant native is that a highly concentrated 12th house is a matter of little bit concern and worry only if you are not well prepared and cautious. If you are cautious, then you do not have to worry about anything. But yes, friends, in your case, as you can fairly see, that Mercury has got the rulership of your 8th house and it has also got the rulership of your 11th house as well. So I would say that all sort of engagement, social interaction needs to be monitored very carefully. So let's say, for example, if you are suddenly getting introduced to some person and you do not know about the credibility of that person, authenticity of that person, and you are being forced to sign a document, get into agreement, get into partnership, give your word. So try to refrain from any sort of these kind of engagement, commitments and agreements during this transit of Mercury in your 12th house. And lastly, friends, like, there is nothing much which I can add over here, but I would just say that your commercial activities, and more than that, your people management and the networking, your social influence needs to be monitored very carefully. If you have been put forth in a situation where you have to give your comments, you have to give your opinion, and situation seems to be very sensitive, it will be better for you to refrain from saying anything, because you might have some good intention, but those words might be misinterpreted. So that is the kind of energy which is getting generated. So remain a bit cautious, remain careful, and try to keep a low profile till the time, at least and specifically, your ascendant lord is not going to come out of your 12th house. Moving ahead, friends, now for all the Sagittarius ascendant natives, the transit of Mercury is going to take place in your 11th house. So friends, as you know this thing, that Mercury is an important planet for you, because Mercury has got the rulership of all the houses which represents your public life, whether it's the 7th house or whether it's the 10th house. So whether it's about your public image or whether it's about the way you get perceived in the world. So that is a domain which gets controlled by the planet Mercury. And in the transit, Mercury is going to be entering your 11th house, which can be seen as a very good time. So I would say, friends, that keep your social life active, because very soon, as you know this thing, that even the planet Jupiter, which is your ascendant lord, it is also going to be coming out of your second house. It is going to be entering your third house, and the concentration of the planets in your 11th house of wish fulfillment, hope, it is creating a very good energy. So I would say that keep your social life active. The more you are going to interact with people, you never know, some kind of opportunity might be waiting for you even within those social interactions only. And I would say that even in your commercial activity, in any sort of your professional important decision making, so the planetary time period is actually has started to become very favorable for you right from the beginning of the month of November. So take the bull by the horns, take the chance, ask for the raise which you deserve, take the accountability of the work, and rewards, good connection, opportunities is something which can be seen as the theme of the transit of Mercury in your 11th house. Your commercial activities and moreover your social life is actually going to get brightened up because of the transit of Mercury in your 11th house. Moving ahead, friends, for all the Capricorn ascendant natives, the transit of Mercury is going to take place in your 10th house, which can be seen as a very good time. Friends, try to understand this thing, that whenever we talk about anything to do or the right approach of propitiating your ascendant lord planet Saturn, so it can only be done by either remaining very serviceful, very dutiful, showcasing, demonstrating strong work ethics, which is the 6th house. And the second way is showcasing good morals, you know, being very philanthropic, doing good deeds, which is the ninth house. So both of these houses are being ruled by the planet Mercury for you guys. So now friends, like definitely for long you have been going through any sort of hardship in your line of work. So the transit of Mercury in your 10th house can improve your work related condition. The second thing is that if you are a very hardworking person and lately you have been getting this kind of notion that all what you are doing is just the hard work, but your hard work is not getting the limelight. It is not getting acknowledged or, you know, kind of rewarded by the people of authority or by your bosses. So I would say that the transit of your 6th house and the 9th house lord in the 10th house can create those positive acknowledgements for you guys. And let's say, for example, if your line of work entails anything to do with sales, media, marketing, language expertise, you are an actor, performing actor, anything to do with working with your skill, public speaking, presentation. So I would say the transit of Mercury in your 10th house is actually going to improve your work condition, make your interpersonal relationship with your bosses, that can also improve, and some work related travel, new opportunities can also be foreseen with the transit of Mercury in the 10th house for all the Capricorn ascendant natives. Moving ahead friends, for all the Aquarius ascendant natives friends, so in your case, if you will try to look at over here, that Mercury becomes a very important planet for you, because Mercury to begin with has got the rulership of your 5th house, and it has also got the rulership of the 8th house. So friends, like whenever we talk about the risk taking abilities of the Aquarians, whenever we talk about thinking innovative out of the box, because 5th house is your intelligence and 8th house is something which is hidden. So all of that aptitude and intelligence of the Aquarians comes from the planet Mercury. So its transit in the 9th house can be seen as a very good time. So let's say, for example, if in your case you are in any way, you are engaged in higher studies, anything to do with the fields of law, teaching, or being a professor, being a trainer. So the transit of Mercury in the 9th house is definitely going to be creating some very positive energy for you guys. And if in any way, any sort of, you know, stock market, trading, interest and engagement, involvement in films, television, media related business as well. So I would say the transit of Mercury in the 9th house is creating a positive energy. Now, whether it can be seen as from the perspective of new travels, new opportunities, financial gain, or whether from the perspective of some, you know, your mind getting attuned towards the religious austerities, spiritual activities. So even from that perspective, the transit of Mercury in your 9th house is definitely going to be creating some positive news for all the Aquarius ascendant natives. And lastly, friends, for all the Pisces ascendant natives, the transit of Mercury is going to take place in your 8th house. So friends, try to understand this thing, that Mercury has got the rulership of your 4th house and your 7th house. So I would say, friends, that this is not the right time for you guys to stress too much on the account of relationship. So now, whether you are in a relationship but things lately started going through any sort of difficulties, or you are single, you're on a lookout but things are not working out, you are just stressed. So I would say try to not get stressed on any of the matter of the relationship. I've already mentioned this thing at the beginning of this video, that the transit of these like inner planets is not of something which is going to create a lasting problem. So the problems or the opportunity created by the planet Mercury, it is a very small window. So whether if it is going to create some opportunity for you, so you have to remain very proactive to encash on that. And even if it is going to create some confusion or some difficulty, so that is going to get removed in a very small span of time. So I would say the transit of the Mercury in the 8th house is a time to contemplate, to meditate, devote yourself for spiritual austerities. But this is not the time to get stressed on any sort of resentment, any of the past wounds, or getting into the conflict mode in the relationship. So that is the only one thing which I want to advise to all the Pisces ascendant natives. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to say as a part of my inputs for this upcoming transit of the planet Mercury in the Libra sign for all the ascendants. For furthermore updates and notifications on the divine signs of Vedic astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page.